Okay, here we come now. First of all, the final summation will come first from the opposition side. And let me tell you a little bit about how the final summation works, okay? This is basically the last chance for each side to let you know their main point. So some questions that they received, they might factor this in. Some of the points that they didn't get a chance to refute. Some of the opportunities to defend themselves in case of imminent attack, as we saw in the middle of the debate. Now we will have a verbal retort, perhaps. And we'll begin with the opposition side and then come back to the proposition side to close the debate. So without further ado, let's hear the closing statement from Professor Hackenbush.
Thank you again, Commissioner Gordon. I think it was Lord Acton who said, "Stringlessness corrupts, absolute stringlessness corrupts absolutely." I think we find no better instance of that than in the White House, where we have a man who's answerable only to his own gut. All the money in the world can't buy that golden gut because it goes where it wants. Now, our illustrious opponents, Frickin' Frack, claim that their politicians have no strings attached. Well, I think it's fine that they have their charming little local elections. But let's not pretend their prime minister does not have strings attached. It's just that they're on the other side of the Atlantic. So, to summarize, starting with the very basic constituents of the universe, and moving all the way to the moral order, and with the social order in between, strings are the thing. Stick with strings. Don't trust a man who doesn't have them. Thank you very much.
Very nice, Hackenbush, nicely rendered and appreciatively brief as well. Now let's come over to the proposition side for the last word.
I think it was Miss Piggy famously said, "We'll fight the strings on the beaches, we'll fight them in the land." we say that holds strong.
Yeah, I mean, absolutely. And I just thought it closed by saying that I didn't want this debate to get personal, because, you know, there's two of us, it's one of him. But when he started insulting
my another one, right?
Yeah, but when he started insulting my cousin's queen, you know, that was taking it too far. And I just have to say, I think the way that you couldn't remember your third or fourth point suggested that somebody else was speaking for you in this debate. Now let's take this outside.
No. Excuse me just a minute. I think it's a point of personal privilege. Some concession is due to my advanced age. You understand? I don't know how old you guys are, but I'm 112. And when you get to be my age, well, parts of your body start behaving like this. I'm a little bit swollen. My memory's not perfect. Some say I'm well precise, but sometimes I miss a point or two. But I think for 112, I'm doing all right. That's all I'm going to say.
Well, yes. And that's a foul point. Which is like saying thank you very much to Gordon and the University of Pittsburgh.
Thank you, everyone.
Okay, goodbye, cyberspace. Thank you for watching. See you later.
Right. It's time to raise the curtain on the Muppet Show tonight. Why do we